Hello, this is your chef Dennis Kalaman, and welcome to my YouTube channel. We have a live show cooking today. We're doing sushi, tempura, and hot warm salad, hot salad. So I have with my special guest, Chef Rene. It's my good friend. And I want to introduce you. He's my good friend. He's working in this industry for a long time, and he knows what he's doing. So, guys, are you ready? Let's cook. So here's Chef Rene.
Hello, good morning, guys. Morning.
Yes.
Today.
Yeah.
Yeah. Today we're going to do. Prawn tempura and vegetable tempura. So we start doing the prawns by means of stretching it.
So yeah, stretching it. Do you have any cold in Japan?
Yeah, they call it nobashi.
Nobashi. Oh, yeah, that's good.
Yeah. So,
first, how are you gonna do it?
First, we need to fill it. The prawns.
Mm-hmm. So guys, watch out, yeah.
Make sure leave the tail.
Yeah. So you need to leave the tail. So we're doing a prawn now, yeah, for a tempura. So watch and learn, guys. Drop some comments if you have question and anything. And by the way, to those who have not yet subscribed, please subscribe now and click the like button, notification bell, and comments and suggestion. So yeah. So right now we're doing taking off the shell of the prawn. So you can buy this prawn from your local. What they call it, seafood market, or you can buy it from the big supermarket. Cool. The size of the prawn maybe
32 40.
Yeah, 32 40 is the size of the prawn. So yeah, so what you're doing now, chef?
Now we need to remove the here, the black in here. Yeah, remove that one.
So you need to remove the vein.
Vein, yes. Careful, because.
So what you doing? Just cutting the top.
Yeah. Make sure you move it.
Yeah, and remove, because that one is not good. When you eat it, it doesn't taste nice. So you need to remove that one, the black part of the prawn. So now, slowly, we're cutting it.
I need to change my knife.
So, chef is changing the knife. So guys, if you have comments, write down.
Now going to stretch it.
So
there's different types of how to stretch the prawns for tempura. First, you can do like this. Don't cut the yeah, just like a little bit.
Angle, yeah? A little bit on the belly side.
You can do like this, yes. Squeeze
and then press it.
Press it. Yeah, that's the first one. There's another one. It's at the same like this. You need to cut as well. And then here. Side. Yeah, both side.
Both side?
Yeah. another one.
So, Chef, what do you learn this technique?
When I work in a Japanese restaurant.
Back home in Philippines or?
Back home, yeah. And then,
so guys, watch out. Yeah, there's a technique of how you stretch your prawn.
Yeah.
Normally, when you're doing a tempura, you need to stretch the prawn so that it's got bigger, and it's
you can
nicer as well the design.
Yes.
So
like that.
Like that. Oh, so you got three technique now. There's a third one or fourth one?
No. Yes.
Just press it. Yeah.
Yeah. Just press it. And then here, because look, it's already stressed anyway. Look, but the first, this one is a basic, the one that you cut here. Yeah.
Show it again, Chef.
Yeah, the one.
Like that, slowly. Yeah.
Then squeeze it. And the other one is you know, the same like that here, cut here, but you need to cut the side.
Side, okay.
Yeah. You can stretch more. That's so why it looks like a very.
I can't imagine how many prawn you're doing before when you're working in a Japanese restaurant.
Yes. Okay.
Maybe 1,000 a day. 1,000 prawn.
Yeah.
Which restaurant is that, Chef? Saisaki, or?
Yeah, Saisaki. I worked there, but it's not. I didn't work there for a long time. I just expat, you know, opening.
Ah, just the opening.
Now, make sure you remove this. Yeah, you clean it.
Why? Why is that, yeah. Chef?
Because you know when you fry it, it's the color will change.
Splash.
Yeah.
So and also it splash as well because there's a water on the tail, isn't it?
Yeah, there's a water in the tail. Yeah, you need to remove it.
So you need to remove the black part of the tail.
Yes. Not low.
Wow, look at that.
Yeah.
So now you're done.
Now done.
So your prawn is done for your tempura, prawn tempura. If you love prawn, this is how you do it. So you don't need to go to a Japanese restaurant and make some. You can make your own. So and also, we're using this one, Chef. It's yeah. Japanese flour.
Yes.
For tempura. It's tempura especially flour. Designed for
tempura.
Tempura. So you can buy it on Amazon or you can buy it on a Japanese supermarket.
So before we start with this tempura butter, we at least we clean it, wash it a little bit.
So we need to wash it.
Yeah.
After you stretch it, you need to wash it. So that all the
dry it up.
Then you can dry.
Yeah.
So it's not just stretch it. You wash it, dry it, because you don't want the water on the. On the prawn. Why is that, Chef? Why you need to dry the prawn?
So that you can get a good quality when you fry it. Without water in it. Just the tempura butter.
Okay.
Yeah, now.
So now you got the dry prawn stretch already.
Now we're doing the tempura butter.
So you're doing the tempura butter. So do you have ice on the... On the bowl, Chef, why is that? Do you have ice on that one?
There is why I put ice because it will helps to become crispy, the tempura.
Okay.
To make it crispy.
So normally we have a cold, very, very cold water.
Yeah.
In UK, some, I think some they're using, what do you call it? The
sparkling water.
Sparkling, yeah.
Yeah.
So this tempura butter is already designed for the tempura. So yeah. So you put water, ice, and flour. So mix it until it's the butter consistency. So yeah, when you're making it, not too much. Maybe half a cup, or how many cup is that, Chef?
One cup is okay.
One cup, okay.
It depends upon the prawns, how many prawns you need to cook.
Yeah, how many prawns. And also, you can make a vegetarian option on this one, Chef?
Yeah, we can do a vegetarian option. Later on, we try
vegetables.
Vegetables, yes.
Hello. Write down comments if you want to ask questions. Write down comments so that I know that you're here, so I can read your comment and I tell to Chef, our special guest chef all the time, to our what do you call it, cooking show with Chef Dennis and Chef Rene. Now, so now we've done the butter, Chef. This is done.
Yeah, that's done. So we start. We need to heat up the oil.
Okay. So a lot of oil.
Yeah, should be deep fry.
So okay. So you need a deep fryer.
Yeah.
If you don't have deep fryers like this, you just use your pan. And then how many temperatures?
That's 100.
So if you have a temperature like this,
80 to 100,
you can see how much the temperature of your oil already. But if you don't have, maybe Chef will show you how what is the technique to know that the oil is ready. Yeah. Do you have technique on that one, Chef?
Yes, just try one first.
Okay, splash a little bit.
Splash a little bit of water on it too. Not yet.
Not yet, okay.
So we need to wait for that. While we're waiting, we can, you call this?
Put the flour.
Oh yeah, put flour in it. Yes, before we put in the tempura butter.
So what's the reason, Chef? Why you put flour?
So that when you soak it in the tempura butter, it will
stick,
yes.
Okay. So guys, you need the flour. You can use as well the tempura flour?
No.
No? Yeah. So you using a plain flour?
Yeah, just use the plain flour. Tempura flour is expensive.
Yeah, that's true. So I bought that one from Amazon around 6 pounds. So very expensive. But it worth it because it's nice. You can use a normal flour as well, Chef?
Yeah, you can use normal flour, but lots of process. Yes.
What do you mean process? Like you put something on the plain flour, or?
Yeah. Because this one is already mixed.
Okay. Do you know what's the mixtures of this?
This one, lots of modern standard of how to mix the one. Some, you put eggs on it. Eggs.
Okay.
Yeah, they don't use it.
So yeah, I remember when I was working in Shangri-La, we put the egg on the water and then we add the flour.
Some are using, you call this, they put some egg white.
Just egg white.
Like almost you're doing a meringue.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then they add there.
Mm-hmm.
So that your tempura will like fluffy.
Okay. So this one is already ready.
Yeah,
you don't need to put any egg or...
Yeah, just put a little bit. If during the winter time, you don't need to put some ice because the water is very cold.
Okay.
So just add the mix, that's it. Or use the sprinkling water, it's good.
But okay.
If you don't have, you need to buy that, so just use normal water.
Yeah. So that's another option, sparkling water or a normal water, but make sure it's very, very cold. So if it's not cold, you put ice so that the water will be cold. So recap, we stretch already the prawn and then we dip on the normal flour, plain flour. And then we've done the butter, and then we're waiting for the oil to be ready, heat it up, and we're cooking the first step. We're doing the tempura step by step. So guys, if you are new on the live show, we've done already the, what do you call it, stretching up the prawn. We put flour on the prawn, and then we've done the tempura butter. Okay guys, write down comments if you want some shout out or something. And by the way, I want to greet my mom. Happy birthday. My nephew, Gab Gab from Italy, happy birthday. My nephew from Philippines, Aegon, happy birthday. They all birthday today from 15, 16, and also my brother Joseph, 16, 18 and 19, from 15, 16, 18, 19. So they're all birthday. So shout out, happy birthday, enjoy your day. And we're back to what we're doing. So while we're waiting, chef, what do you need? What do you call it? Chopstick. You need chopstick on cooking the.
Yeah, you can use chopstick or no.
Or no,
what do you call this?
Tong. Tong.
Tong. Almost there.
Mm-hmm. So let's see if the oil is about to.
You try. Yeah, almost, almost.
Almost. So you see, it's the bubble. You see the temperature. How much? So we're about 130 is still going. So maybe around 100. How many, chef? 180.
Yeah, 180.
180. So in
normal price 180, 170.
Yeah, in Japanese they have this they call it for tempura only, the bronze.
Nabi.
The bronze, no?
Nabi.
Nabi, you call that nabi?
Yeah. Nabi, the bronze
pan like this, but yeah. It's bigger, but
brown.
The bronze is nice because it's contain the right temperature, isn't it?
Yeah.
They call it nabi in Japanese.
Nabi, nabi.
Okay. So you call this you call this
now it's stuck. I think it's ready now.
You see?
You can put you call 2-3 in your from your hands. Like this, 3. Like that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's you can do that one.
3?
Yeah, 3 at the same time.
Okay.
But if you cannot do that, just do one.
Yeah, when you're in hurry, 3.
Yeah, when you're in hurry, 3.
Yeah, because in the restaurant, you need
Because you don't have enough oil. And don't put it straight away down.
Okay.
Yeah.
Slowly, slowly, yeah?
Yes.
So that it doesn't, what's the reason, chef? Doesn't stick on the bottom or?
Yeah. And look this, yeah.
How about the wisik-wisik? No wisik-wisik?
Yeah, we can do that. Mm-hmm. We cook all at the same time. It's big enough. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. If you're cooking a lot, maybe more oil, yeah? What do you think,
oil.
Chef?
More oil. At least deep fry.
Mm-hmm.
If deep fry, that means lots of oil.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So in
I'm not expert in doing this, you know. But when I work in a you call this. Oh
Japanese
my God! Do like this.
So you do the wisik wisik.
Wisik wisik. To have a design.
See? You see what the chef is doing? He wisik wisik the
wisik wisik.
Yeah, splash the butter from from this chopstick to so that the design is there. That's why I'm wondering, it's for tempura, you have the design.
Yeah, look, there's a design now. Look.
Wow. Look,
because of the wisik wisik.
So nice.
That's because of the wisik wisik.
Because of the wisik wisik.
Yeah. And you can stretch the cross if you want.
What do you mean, chef?
Stretch it. Straight, straight.
Ah, you might. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So you need to watch out because sometimes it tends to curl if you don't do properly stretch your front, it curls. So it's not straight. So you need to properly stretch your front.
Okay.
Oh wow, look at that. Very nice. So normally you using chopstick for this or chef?
You can use the tong.
Tong.
Most
convenient.
Convenient. If you don't know how to use the chopstick, use the tong.
Yeah. Okay.
So only for
show.
Yeah.
Show cooking.
Show cooking. Yes. Now.
You see guys, how to make tempura, your tempura done. You don't need to put salt on the front?
No need, no need.
No need. So just the tempura flour and that's it. So do you have any sauce on that one or?
Yeah, I am. Now I'm gonna use for this sriracha mayo.
Sriracha mayo?
We're doing fusion now, sriracha mayo.
So it's a fusion now, yeah? You see how the chef is doing? He's splashing the tempura flour, tempura butter. And then the fusion now, nowadays, normally it's a tempura sauce, no?
Yeah.
Made of hondashi and hondashi and what is it called? It's a lot of ingredients for the tempura sauce, hondashi and soy sauce, I think.
Yeah.
Now, because of the fusion now, they're making sriracha mayo. It's nice as well for the prawn. Or you can improvise as well. So, you can improvise as well, chef, or?
Yeah, you can improvise whatever you want.
Whatever you want, it's your choice.
You know, in the new generation, we need to create our own style. You can create your own techniques. You adapt how to do
the basic, and
the
then
basic, but you can add on it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you make your own twist, and it become yours.
Yes.
So, but you need to start with the basic.
Yes.
Yeah, how you always when you're doing food, start with the basic. And you add something, it becomes different.
Yeah, even the Japanese now, they fusion most of the.
So the sauce that we're making is sriracha.
Yeah, sriracha mayo.
Sriracha mayo. So sriracha, you can buy it from a Chinese shop or.
Yeah, even in the groceries you can buy now.
What does it look like? It's like a chili sauce.
Yeah, it's like chili sauce. Yeah. But chili sauce.
But sriracha.
No, sriracha.
Hello, Daniel. Daniel, say hello from.
Hello, Daniel.
He said the tempura is very nice. And then you put mayo. Oh wow!
Yeah.
No, I feel hungry now, so I can smell the. Can smell the butter, the tempura.
Our the oil is not so very hot. I think I need to move it. Yeah.
So the vegetables as well, you can do as the same?
Yeah, we can do vegetable. That's why very important when you cook a tempura is lots of oil.
Okay.
Deep fry. But this one is we don't know now. We don't have enough. Little bit more supposed to be. Yeah.
Maybe we can add more.
Yeah.
So when you're doing tempura, you need a lot of oil. At least half of this container. Maybe 1 liter.
We add more.
So you add a little bit more. But in the beginning, you need to put your oil so that it's all hot. So the tempura is really nice.
Not too hot.
But it turns out a nice one. It's golden color, no? How do you know it's ready, Chef?
It's just the color. It process takes you can cook prawns very quickly. Anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, but if so, you cook in the navi, it's very good. You can get the nice color.
Golden brown.
Yeah.
But some I saw that they put the breadcrumbs on that one, so that's different, though.
Yeah, it's different. Yeah, you can use the breadcrumbs. Some right here they're using coconut crumbs mixed with
tempura coconut. They call it, innit? But that one's in a frozen, with coconut and with the breadcrumbs. But this one is fresh one. So from the scratch we're doing it. So if you're just come now, we're doing the tempura. We started from stretching the prawn, and then we done the butter. And then we fry it, so our tempura is done. And then now we put in the plate. Lovely. So guys, thank you very much to all who subscribe. Keep on supporting my channel. Keep on watching on my live show cooking, and share my video or share my channel to your family and friends. And also, Chef Rene, do you have a YouTube channel as well?
No, just support my granddaughter's channel.
Okay.
YouTube channel.
What is it called, Chef?
Boost Babies.
Boost Baby. V as in Victory. O-Z?
Z, yeah.
O-Z Babies. Adventure, innit?
Yeah.
So yeah, so support as well Chef Serene's YouTube channel, Boost Baby Adventure. So yeah, so we're done already with the tempura. Look at that. Woo, lovely. Look. You see that? See the sauce? This is mayo and Chirachi. And then the tempura, we done it. It's crispy. You see how crispy is the tempura? Normally when they do it, we just standing. You see? Guys, are you happy? Write down comments, please. If you want to shout out. Once again, happy birthday to my mom. My brother, Joseph Kaalaman, my mom, Milagros Kaalaman. And by the way, on the weekend, we have this Father's Day. Happy Father's Day to all fathers in the world. So, yeah. And Gab Gab, happy birthday yesterday. And today is Egon. Hello, Daniel. So, yeah, we're doing the... Next is we're doing vegetables. Daniel is asking if we can do vegetables. Yes, we can do vegetables as well. But we need to make the oil hot again because we done the tempura. So we need to So by the way, Chef, after this, you can still use the oil?
Yeah, I can still use the oil.
You can keep the oil. It's anyway, it's clean oil.
You can keep the oil.
So don't worry about wasting the oil, but you cannot waste the oil. You can reuse it. So this is the vegetables. So any vegetables you can use?
Yeah, you can use asparagus, carrots.
Baby asparagus, young one.
Yeah, baby asparagus, baby carrots.
Yeah.
And the
broccoli, how about broccoli?
Broccoli, the other one, you call this.
Baby broccoli.
Yeah, baby broccoli and the pumpkin florets.
Pumpkin?
Yeah.
Okay, guys, you can use a lot of vegetables, but it's up to you what vegetable you like. And you cut it the same way that the prawn look like. So cut it straight like this, and some they cut it like a butterfly. So same process. So this is the finished product for the tempura. So it's look amazing, isn't it? Guys, write down comments, please. So what we're doing now, sir?
Now we're doing the we call this vegetable tempura.
So yeah, vegetable tempura. So this is how you cut.
Yeah, this one. I just take my green chopping board.
So we need to have the green chopping board to have a vegetable tempura. So guys, thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe. Write down comments below and share my video to your family and friends who love to see how to cook. So we're doing a live show cooking, maybe we once a month or twice a month we're doing this. So any suggestion, any comments, or any you want us to do for our live show cooking, just write down comments and let's see what we can do. So now what you're doing, chef? You're cutting the vegetables?
Yeah, I'm cutting the you call this aubergine.
Aubergine. So what kind of aubergine is that, chef? Why is it so small?
Yeah. Filipino.
Native.
That's it.
So you can use a big aubergine as well?
Yeah, you can normal. Yeah, you can use the big aubergine, why not? But just make sure you have a nice cutter, like you can use the peeler.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
It must be thin.
Yeah.
You cut it like very, not very thin, but must be thin so that it's easier to cook. So, yeah.
Now this one you need to put some salt on it. Pepper.
So you're gonna season the vegetables, yeah?
Yeah, you need to season it.
Oh, lovely. So for all the vegetarian people who loves to eat the vegetables, so this is you need to do for making a tempura. So it's completely a vegetarian because the flour is a vegetarian. And yeah, if you cannot eat the prawn, you can make vegetables. It's nice as well. So you can use broccoli as well, cauliflower.
Yeah, broccoli, cauliflower, carrots.
Carrots, cauliflower, broccoli, all sorts of vegetables. You can use as well peppers.
Yeah, peppers. You can use. Yeah, that's it.
So put salt and pepper on the vegetables, and then what's next, chef?
Just use the same process with the prawns.
Same process, you put flour as well.
Yeah.
So make sure the vegetables is dry, no water.
Yeah.
You don't want to have a water on the oil because it's splash. And you don't want to have an accident. Mm-hmm. So if you think that your tempura butter is not enough, you can make, you can add more.
Yes.
And then add cold water. So add a little bit so that you get.
What's the water?
It's a salt.
It's a salt.
Okay, you put water, little bit. Just the same process of you making it, but this time you just add it up, and then what do you call it? Put some ice as well, no?
Yeah, you can put ice because there's still ice on it, so.
Okay, it's still cold.
It's cold.
So what's the reason again, chef, for the ice?
Just to make it crispy.
Make it crispy. Yeah. So make sure. You can use water or sparkling water as well, yeah?
Yes, sparkling water. Without ice is okay, no worry. Without ice, you can cook tempura without ice. But without. Much better if you put ice on it.
Okay.
For the better...
Better outcome.
Outcome, yes. Mm. Now we try it, if it's okay. Mm, not yet.
Not yet?
Oh, yes. Almost there.
Almost, almost.
Yeah.
You see that? Almost that yet. So, how do you know when it's ready, chef? When the vegetables start floating, or?
Yeah, when the vegetables start floating. And also you need to turn it,
Turn it all the time?
All the time, so that it balance.
The cooking. Yeah. So this time, because you cut it the vegetables thin, you don't need to cook it longer in the pan, any, until it's golden brown.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. See what the chef is doing? Two at the same time. In between of his finger. So you don't have to drop it quick. Just slowly, slowly you drop it. See, this is how you do the vegetable tempura. So you got prawn tempura, and then you got vegetable tempura. Lovely. Look at that. Golden brown. You see? See that? Write down comment, guys, if you want to shout out. If you have any question, write down comment.
Mm-hmm. Just this one.
You see? But you need to watch the tempura because it's easy to... because the oil is hot already, or chef?
Yeah,
always have to. So you need to watch out because it's easy to cook until it's golden brown. You turn flip it over, and then golden brown again on the other side, and then you chef will do the wisik wisik.
The wisik wisik, if you want without wisik wisik, it's okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can have as well without wisik wisik, but it's nicer if you put some wisik wisik. I mean, it's splashing the design. It's the design. You see how chef is doing? But it's up to you. If you're not the expert, maybe you wisik-wisik the whole kitchen. At the end of your tempura, all the tempura flour is in the floor. Very nice, guys. So we done the tempura. So what's next you're gonna do, chef?
Bro, shrimp hot salad. It's not spicy, yeah. Warm salad.
Warm salad. So next of this, after we done the tempura, we're doing the warm salad. So stay tuned, guys. Write down comments if you need. You want to be a shout out, please.
The dessert.
Click like button as well, so I know that you're here. Say hello. Look at that, chap. It's very nice. Nice color. Look at that. Lovely. For a nice for vegetarian people option. So if you have a party or you have a small gathering, you can make tempura to impress your family or your friends. If one of your friends is vegetarian, so you can use a vegetable tempura and a prawn tempura. So prawn tempura is like this. Freshly made prawn tempura. And then the vegetable tempura is like this. So you can advance this, or once you cook it, you need to eat it right away.
Yeah.
You cannot advance cooking and then put in the oven, or no? Reheat it.
No need.
No need. You just eat right this.
Yeah, cook alam it.
You cook it alam
it. Yeah, tempura is not going to be cook advance. Yeah, at least 4 hours. Mm-hmm. You want the crispy still there?
Yeah.
Yeah, cook a minute. It's take only if you can't cook it very quickly anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's vegetarian, yes, we are vegetarian. What do you cook with asparagus? You call this broccoli is really good. The you know what you call
the flower.
Yeah.
The baby broccoli.
Yeah.
Yeah, that one is nice. With the stem.
Yes.
Baby broccoli or baby purple. Carrots. They call it purple broccoli as well.
Yeah. Purple broccoli.
Very nice.
You can call the dog pumpkin.
So next chef, what are you gonna do? Ito gawin na lang at sa na to. Kasi ano na eh.
Mm.
Pork meat.
So we start with this prawn salad.
So next, we're doing the prawn salad now, hot prawn salad. So guys, write down comments, suggestion. And by the way, support the chef's granddaughter's YouTube channel. So what are you doing now, chef?
Just clean the...
clean the tail?
Yeah.
Add the...
Mm-hmm.
So take off the black part on the back.
Yeah.
The bean, they call it the bean.
Yes. And then also the fry.
So you need to deep fry as well this one.
Yes. Yeah.
With deep-fry. The butter as well, or?
Yeah, you can use normal
flour.
Normal flour. Mm-hmm.
So this time guys we're doing the hot prawn salad, yeah? Well, it make me hungry now. Delicious. Write down comments, guys. If you have question or you need to chat out, write down comments.
Okay, let's start with this. Mm-hmm. We put eggs in it.
Eggs.
Yeah.
So one egg.
One egg. You can use tempura butter. We use tempura butter.
Yeah, use the. Use tempura butter or normal flour is okay with the egg.
Yeah, because we have already there, we use tempura butter.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Just add this one. Bit of water.
So where do you learn this, chef? This salad.
I learned this when I was working in a long time ago in I think Triple B Express. That time the you call this my our boss asking us to create some you calls new products.
Yeah, the, new menu, or new recipe.
New menu, new recipe. So that time all of us said that you can like a competition.
Okay. So how you come out with this salad, chef? So this is your entry.
Yeah, one of my entries. This one is the almost there. You know, salad is very quick. We can do it very, very quickly. So just stay tuned.
Stay tuned, guys. So chef is making the butter already for the prawn salad. So butter is with egg, lard, and water. And because we have remaining of the tempura butter, we use that as well. It's the same. We can use that as well. So now the tempura is almost ready.
So, for you call this for salad, we're using this cocktail mayo.
Fruit cocktail, mayo, and prawn.
Yeah.
Oh wow!
We put the salad here. So we have three now.
So guys, this the ingredients for the what they call it hot prawn salad. We have fruit cocktail in juice. You can buy it in your local shop or local supermarket. And then peeled cucumber cut in cubes. And also we have this gorgeous mayonnaise. Heinz mayonnaise or any kind of mayonnaise. So yeah. The tempura vegetables is cooking. It's almost ready. So we done already the prawn tempura, and now we're doing the veg tempura, and now we're doing the next one is we're doing the hot prawn salad. It's the invention of the chef. From the restaurant before in Triple B or it's Triple B. He's the head chef there before he become in Shangri-La. So he worked in Triple B. I don't know guys if you remember the Triple B. It combines with the saisaki,
duds
and what else? That's the other one.
Kamayan,
yeah.
And Triple B Express. I don't know, it's still
Working or still open or no?
Yeah, that's it. The vegetable tempura.
Oh, wow, look at that. Look at that, guys. Vegetable tempura ready. Well, done.
We're frying the prawns. Okay.
The prawn now. We're doing the prawn salad, yeah?
Yeah.
So we're frying the prawn first.
Now you need what is how become a hot salad?
How is that, chef?
It's how become a warm salad.
Okay.
You need to watch it.
So yeah, guys, watch it. Yeah, how we become this prawn salad become hot salad. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Actually, you can use this if you have lots of tempura, prawn tempura, you can use it.
The tempura?
Yes.
Okay.
Just add this one. Now, I start on the other side. So, that become quick.
So, we're cooking the prawn.
Okay.
And then, what are you going to do with the other side?
Now, we're going to start this salad now.
Okay.
So, make sure you remove the juice on it. Okay.
Oh, lovely, chef. Now I'm happy now because I'm hungry. I can see the prawns is calling me now. Look at that. Big one.
Yeah.
Because of the butter.
Yeah, because of the butter.
You see, guys? So, if you want to have a different one aside from tempura, you can use this one, prawn, hot prawn salad, they call it. Chef, one of the chef invention. So it's a winning recipe when it's working in a Triple B.
Okay.
So yeah, drain the water from the can.
Yeah. Mix all together.
Mix all like that.
Yes. And this is only the pepper. Mayonnaise,
that's it. So that's it, guys. You see, fruit cocktail and then cucumber and prawn buttered, easy and delicious.
That's lovely.
Lovely, chef. Oh, now I'm hungry now, chef.
Now start with this. Okay.
See, now we are you're cooking the fruit cocktail with the cucumber.
Mm-hmm.
It's very unusual, yeah, chef. You cook the cucumber and the fruit cocktail.
Yes, unusual, yeah. Unusual.
But it's delicious. So how you find out? You won on this one or?
Yes.
Do you have this competition and you want this recipe?
I want this recipe. Now I have to go here and use it. Okay, mayonnaise.
So while you're still cooking, you cook the mayonnaise as well, chef?
Yeah.
Look at that, guys. So the prawn is easy to cook, and then you cook a little bit of your salad. Look at that. Salad and prawn. Oh, wow.
Okay, what is that there?
Straight to the salad.
Yeah. Okay, you can do it. You can use all this cream.
Cream caramel. Double cream?
Yeah, double cream.
Double cream or mayo?
And you can put some condensed milk.
With condensed milk?
Yeah.
It's like a salad, yeah?
Yes.
Fruit salad, but warm. So look at that. You see, guys? So yep. Cook it slowly as well, or? Salt, pepper?
No need, don't need.
No need. Oh, guys, look.
Okay.
Look at the salad.
Looks hot. That's why you call it hot salad. You have to start.
Look at that. You see? See the salad? Wow.
If you want more sweet, put little bit of condensed milk.
Condensed milk.
Yeah.
Prawn and fruit salad. But it's hot.
Look at that. This you call this put some color.
Wow, very nice, chef.
Big portion.
Big portion for the.
Big portion.
For me, big portion for me. Look, guys. So we done the tempura, veg tempura, and hot prawn salad. Guys, are you listening? You're taking this. Take note of this, guys.
I just want.
Ay, bari yung ano. Oh, slowly. So what we're doing now, chef? Next?
We're doing the
sushi.
Sushi, yeah.
The dragon.
Dragon, we make it dragon.
Dragon sushi, guys. We'll try this one. Yeah,
put all together. And you have a lot of now
crunchy, huh? You heard my things, crunchy. What are you doing now, chef?
We're doing the you call this sushi.
Sushi, okay.
Yeah, rolls.
So guys, we're doing sushi rolls. What do you call it in Japanese, chef?
I don't know that Japanese about the dragon.
Dragon, Mondragon. Mondragon.
Ask Google, what's Japanese of dragon?
No, I mean the roll. We call it maki, no?
Yeah.
Maki roll. So you learned this from Triple B as well, or?
No. I'm not expert in you call this
sushi.
Sushi, I'm not expert, but I have idea. I can create something different.
Okay, how do you?
Because I don't want to. No, I always do my own style.
Okay.
Yes.
You create your own.
I create my own. I just adapt a little bit and then add.
That's good, chef. Because what do you call it? Only you need to follow the procedure, the basic, and then you just add.
Yeah, add or change it.
Or change it, okay.
Now, okay, we start with this. I have ready here.
What's that, chef?
Rice, sushi rice.
Sushi rice. How do you make the sushi rice, chef?
Yeah, just cook it in 30 minutes with soap.
So what rice do you need?
I use the Japanese rice.
Japanese rice or California rice, no?
Yeah.
Or short grain rice.
Yes. And then because it's not enough.
So you can, what do you call it?
Sushi vinegar.
You can buy sushi vinegar in the shop?
Yeah, lots there.
Lots.
No need but to cook from scratch. No need.
From scratch, okay. But normally when you do the, before we're doing it, we're doing
Reduce
the vinegar and then put sugar while it's still hot and then a little bit of salt and that's it. So guys, watch on this one. We're doing the dragon, yeah? Dragon sushi. So you need the clean film on your sushi mat. The bamboo, they call it sushi mat. So chef is guys, you're watching. So first the rice and then the nori. They call it nori.
You can use the tempura. Yeah, this one much better. We use the tempura.
Yeah.
For dragon, much better this one.
Tempura.
Yeah. So, all purpose. Yeah.
Guys, you're watching.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. A little bit more. Now, ready? So just add avocado. First, the avocado.
So rice, and then the nori, and then you put the your peelings. What kind of peelings do you need to put there, Chef?
I'm using avocado.
Avocado.
Yeah, I just want to let you know that sushi is a healthy foods.
Yeah.
Yes. Most especially with avocado, it's a healthy one. Like this. Yeah. I'm cutting this very thin.
So you need to leave the other side not cut, or cut it very thin all?
Yeah, very thin all. Yeah, push it.
Push it, yeah.
Push it.
Push it.
Yeah, press it. Press.
Press it down and then...
Press it down and press up, not push it.
Not push it, okay.
Okay. Ooh. Another one.
Look at that. Another one.
If you notice, I spread the rice in the plastic one first. And there's another one. You can put the nori first.
Yeah.
And then put the rice on the top and then turn it.
Yeah, the same.
The same.
This, what do you call it, California maki.
Yeah.
So the rice is outside.
Yeah, and this one you can put, you can roll it in, you call this with black sesame. It's good.
Oh, okay.
A nice color. I need this small one.
So you need to cut it very, very thin.
Yeah. So that you can spread it out properly.
Now you're done.
Now?
So your sushi with the avocado on top. Now you put some cling film.
Okay. You can use this one without
cling film.
Cling film, yeah. We can remove it. And then
press it again.
Press start it.
How you press it, Chef?
When you show, press it, show. Start in the middle and then
make it round, yeah?
Yeah. You can do shape, round, square. Now look.
Dragon now. It looks like dragon. Dragon. Mondragon.
Mondragon. And also when you cut it, make sure don't remove the. Where's my knife now? You have lots of knives there.
Don't remove the cling film.
Don't remove the cling film, because or else you cannot cut properly. Now, when cutting sushi, monkey like this, you start in the middle.
Start in the middle, yeah.
Here. Oh, and then. Hop again. Then hop again. Then that's it.
That's it. Wow, look at that. But you don't need to take off the cling film.
No, we need to take out.
You need to take out. Again, but when you're cutting it with the cling film, yeah?
Yeah, with the cling film, so that the shape's still there. And then again, because you need to finish like that.
Okay.
Especially if you
after you cut it.
Yeah. Especially if you're serving for fine dining. Look, now you have a nice shape. Yeah, and also you need to a little bit the bottom. Now Wait. Okay. I wash my hands. Bit a little bit
design.
Yeah.
Nice, yeah.
Yes. Or you can leave it straight. You can leave it straight, it's up to you.
It's a dragon. Yeah. You can put like this as well, oh. So that they can see the middle. What's inside?
Yeah.
Can you take one, Chef? And show the.
Okay, take the middle. That's it. Yeah.
So look at that, guys. That's the way sushi. Look at that. Very delicious. It's like a dragon with a tail.
Yeah, and you can put some garnish on the top. You can put it's up to you. You can put sriracha if you have chili sauce.
Chili sauce as well.
Yeah, you can put chili sauce on the top.
One by one. Nice. So now it's become dragon now.
I'm shaking.
Why are you shaking, Chef?
I get nervous.
Get nervous because of the dragon?
Yeah. And he will bite me.
He bite you.
Okay. We put some nice color on it. Make it contrast.
Guys, you're getting this.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's it.
Done.
Our show.
So this conclude our show. We got a recap. We done the dragon sushi from the stars. But you can make a normal sushi as well. The same process. And then we done the tempura. We done the vegetable tempura. We done the salad. Warm salad. And that's conclude our
Thank you again. Thank you.
So, any promotion? You have YouTube channel. Done. So, guys, thank you very much.
Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching. See you next time. And also, please subscribe. Write down comments if you have any questions. I will put the menu in descriptions below. And then share the video or share my YouTube channel to your family and friends. And happy birthday to my mom, Milagros. And happy birthday to Gabgab. Happy birthday to Akon. Happy birthday to my brother, Joseph.
And to me, soon.
And to Chef Rene's birthday is coming as well. So, and by the way, on Sunday we have this Father Day. So, guys, thank you for watching, and I hope you learned something or you find this live video useful. And this is your Chef Dennis Calaman. Saying, let's eat good to live good. And any remark, Chef?
Just keep on watching Chef Dennis Calaman's YouTube. I keep on supporting him.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye. And done. And also, Boss Babies. keep on supporting Boss Baby's adventure YouTube channel of Chef Rene's granddaughter. Thank you. Bye-bye.